What's up, peeps? Thanks for joining me. My name is Damon Warren, and this is Day One Tech. And today, I got a phone case. This is by a company called SportsLink. They sent this out to me to test out and try out. Going to give you my honest, unsponsored review of this phone case. So what makes this phone case special? Well, it says it's waterproof, drop-proof, dust-proof, snow-proof. Drop-proof up to 6 feet and change. IPX8 certified, IPX6 dust. So let's take a look inside and see if it holds up to it. Everything they're saying on the box. So the first thing to let you know, they do have this for different phones. I'm going to be putting this on my iPhone 16 Pro. So inside the box, everything's inside the case. You can see it's nice. Hard case there. Please open the charging port cover while installing the case. Press the back case to squeeze the air out and then close the charging port cover to get better touchscreen performance. All we need to do is open up this charging port. So you open up the charging port. So there's a part right here on the side. So it looks like you just, there it is. There you go. So to open it up, this part on the side here, you need to apply some pressure. And this is everything inside here. We got our instruction manual. Little hand lanyard thing, put around your wrist. This is some kind of keychain thing. Cloth. This looks like extra gaskets here. Instructions for waterproof membrane replacement. So if you need to replace the membrane, you get three of those in there. That's nice to know. And here it says notes. Make sure to remove any screen protector before installing your phone into the case. So this case will protect the phone, but you need to take off your screen protectors if you already got one on it before you put it in here. Take a look at the instruction manual here. Okay, it's the case key. So that's probably what I would have used to open it up. Got yourself a water test. All right, so now I'm gonna go over the instructions and see what we get. All right, so I just read the instruction manual. It's really easy. If you plan on using this in the water, the first thing you wanna do is put it together. So you're gonna snap it, don't put your phone in. You're gonna snap it closed, right? All the way around. Open that up for a little bit, just to make sure you can get, okay, go all the way around the case, close the port up, that charging port, make sure that's closed tight. Then you're gonna take it, put it in some water, submerge it, and put something on the top of it and wait about 30 minutes. After the 30 minutes, you're gonna take it, open it up, and see if any water's in it. This is the tool you can use to open it back up. And that goes right in here. And then you just twist, and it pries right back open. So, I'm gonna go test it. All right. So we had it in there about a half hour. Put something on top of it to weigh it down so it wouldn't go anywhere. And you wanna check to see if there's any water inside of it. So now, Gonna open it up. See what we got inside. So we take our little key right here. And it is dry inside. So if I were to go kayaking or something like that, I would just need to put this phone in here. Now, a couple of things to remember when you're using this is that you don't want a screen protector on it. They do give you a cloth to clean it off, because you want the screen clear as possible before you put it in there. And then you just slide it in like that. Put your back on. Make sure you go around the whole thing. Snap it in. And I always say go around it twice just to make sure, right? And you're gonna open up this port and try to get as much water out, try to get as much air out as possible, right? Kind of like burp it. And then close your seal. Other things you wanna do? You getting ready to go underwater with it? Put it in the camera mode. And make sure in your settings that you have the volume button set to take the picture or video. So in the case, you can see it does work. Touchscreen works. You do have to put a little extra pressure in it, but it does work. So I will set the camera up the way I'm getting ready to go underwater or whatever. And then I would have the volume buttons to initiate the recording like that. And your side button still works for my 16 Pro. So the camera button works on the 16 Pro. Make sure you keep that closed, that seal. And before you open it up, make sure that it's like this and then open it up. So if there is any water inside that seal, it falls down. You don't wanna go open it like this, because if there is anything in there, no, it might be just sitting around the edge, but it would fall down. So open with it down like this. But make sure before you go in the water, it's all sealed up, ready to go. And you're all set. Waterproof case, dust, snow, going out to snowboarding or anything like that. Provides great protection. Even if you're not going underwater, let's say you're going on some kind of adventure or whatever, right? And it might get a little rough out there. This case is nice and strong and sturdy. So it's not only water and dust, but it's a protective case. So for me, if I were going out to get ready to ride my one wheel or something, I might slap it in this case as opposed to my everyday carry case. And you can put this through here, and then I got a nice little wrist strap, so I don't have to worry about it falling and going anywhere. So I'll put the link to it in the description. Definitely does what it says it was going to do. It was watertight, no problems, buttons work, all the buttons work, and there you go. So if you got any questions, hit me up in the comments. Thanks for watching this video. Hit that like button for me. And until next video, remember, take care of each other. Peace out, and I'll see you all soon.